realizing, of course, it still wasn't finished. So the first thing he did for me was write out the lyrics so that we'd get them correct. And you better believe that this piece of paper, which is what Paul wrote the lyrics on. It's quite a small piece of paper, but I keep it safe in a fireproof safe at home in Malibu, so that when the music business goes completely to shit, I can run to Sotheby's as fast as my legs can carry me. And Paul can save the family. It hasn't come to that yet, but you never know. And in addition, so that we get it correct music-wise, I asked him if he'd do a demo, which he happily did. This was my reel-to-reel tape recorder in my bedroom. He had one in his bedroom as well. And he sat in front of that machine and recorded just a him alone demo of the song insofar as it existed at that point in time. And I thought you might be curious to hear that, just to see how the song began life. So here's World Without Love in its embryonic form.
Lock me away and don't allow the day here inside where I hide with my loneliness. I don't care what you say, I won't say in a world without love.
So that was all well and good, but of course that wasn't the whole song. You know, that wasn't enough to make a record from. So I did have to nag him a little as the day of our session drew near to finish it. And finally he said, oh, okay. And he went into his bedroom with his guitar for like a depressingly short, like 7 or 8 minutes. Really, that actually isn't a joke, that's true. And he came out with the, so I wait and in a while I will see my true love smile. That gorgeous bridge that completed the song. It all fitted together. We loved it. It went on the list for our very first session. The day of our first session, I was thrilled to death. Couldn't sleep the night before. I was so excited. We went into EMI Studios, the one they now call Abbey Road, same place. And, you know, it was famous even then. And just being in there and making our first record was absolutely thrilling. That was the day, I'm convinced of it, that I decided internally that I wanted to be a record producer. Once I figured out what they did, you could hire musicians much better than yourself and tell them what to do. You could tell songwriters, no, you do it a different way and stuff. And they would do it. And, well, what a great job that is. And how cool. So I was thrilled. And we recorded 5 or 6 songs in the course of that day. And by the end of it, the EMI people all came over and listened, we all listened together, and there was no doubt in anyone's mind that World Without Love was going to be our first single. We all thought it might do pretty well. In fact, it did astonishingly well. We were extremely happy because when it came out, went to number one in the UK quite quickly, number one all over Europe, number one eventually in like 32 countries, is an amazing number like that. Finally, including, of course, to our astonishment, utmost delight, number one in America. And that therefore became the song that changed my life forever. And you better believe we celebrated then and we continue to celebrate now whenever the opportunity arises. So what we'd like to do for you, if we could, is do World Without Love as our closing song, since I was lucky enough to get going with that big hit. But we'd also love it if you would join in for this one. Now this is your opportunity to really sing your hearts out, because I know there's a school of thought, of course, that might believe that, you know, this hit record was number one 60 something years ago. Maybe that means that anyone who's old enough to remember when it was number one is automatically too old to remember anything else. Which is something, in my case, again, sometimes this appears to be true. But let's hope. And just in case the lyrics don't come drifting through the mist of time into your old and tired dreams, we do have a cheat sheet for you. So Jeff comes to the rescue. And you've already demonstrated your excellent singing ability on Lady Godiva and so on. So I'm so confident that of your singing.
I'm actually, what we're going to do is leave the last verse of the song entirely to you guys. Because I know you can do it. And by the way, the last verse is, as they say, same as the first. So you will have practiced it as well. You'll be absolutely rocking by your solo verse. So essentially, it could be said that you are closing this evening's show. And I just wanted to add that being your opening act has been a great honor.
Peter, one thing. Can we have them practice first? It's going to be very, very simple. They're all going to sing, "Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Peter. Happy birthday to you."
You're very kind. Thank you, gentlemen. You're very gracious of me. Thank you, Jason. Yes, it's so far so good is all I can say. I'm 79 today, so the only remaining question is where am I going to be doing the gig on my 80th birthday? We'll figure that out. Maybe I should be back here. But
all right.
Thank you, Jeff, for organizing that.
All right.
And they
sounded pretty good.
Oh yeah.
But I think we expect more, don't we?
Yes.
Yes, we do. So finally, full out, loudest yet ever, 79th birthday version of World Without Love, 2, 3, 4.
Please lock me away and don't allow the day here inside where I hide with my loneliness. I don't care what they say, I won't stay in a world without love. But sing out of tune and rain must hide the moon. I'm okay, here I'll stay with my loneliness. I don't care what they say, I won't stay in a world without love.
And the last minute bridge.
So I wait, and in a while I will see my true love smile. She may come, I know not when. When she does, I'm alone. So baby, until then, lock me away and don't allow the day here inside where I hide with my loneliness. I don't care what they say, I will stay in a world without love.
Take it away, Jeff Allen Ross.
Great audience and a great choir.